Hello friends. In the previous video, we learned about the different methods of factorizing algebraic expressions, that is, the common factor method and the regrouping method. Today we will see some examples related to this. Look at these terms. Can you find their common factor? We can write the factors of 33xy like this. Similarly, we can write the factors of 11x square y cube like this. And we can write the factors of the term 22y square z cube like this. We can see that in these three terms, 11y is the only common factor. Now can you factorize the algebraic expression 4x square y plus 10xyz? You can pause the video here and think. Let's see. First of all, we will find the prime factors of all the terms of algebraic expressions in this way and write them as factors. We can see that 2xy is common in both terms. Therefore, we can solve the algebraic expression in this way. Hence, the expression 2xy and 2x plus 5z are factors of 4x square y plus 10xyz. Wasn't that easy? Let's look at another example. What will you do if you wanted to factorize this algebraic expression r minus 5 minus 5pq plus pqr? You can pause the video here to think. You got it right. We will first write the factors of all the terms of this algebraic expression in this way. All these terms do not have any common factors, but between the third term, minus 5pq, and the fourth term, pqr, there is a common factor pq. So we can write the given algebraic expression as follows. Here pq is the common factor in the last two terms. So we can solve it further in this way. We can see here that if we consider r minus 5 as a term, we can write it further in this way. Hence, the factorization of the given expression will be r minus 5 multiplied by 1 plus pq. We can rearrange this expression in another way. If we write the first and last terms together, and write the second and third terms later, what are the common factors you see? Here, r is common in the first and second term, and minus 5 is common in the third and fourth term. So we can write it this way as well. Here we wrote r plus pqr as r multiplied by 1 plus pq. Because we can also write r as 1 multiplied by r. If we multiply both of these, then we get r plus pqr. Similarly, we can also write minus 5 minus 5pq as minus 5 multiplied by 1 plus pq. We can see that here we are getting the same factors. Now practice these questions. You can pause the video here to think. So in this video, we learned factorization of algebraic expressions using the common factor method and regrouping method. Thank you.